I'm Gwenda Joyce, the organizer and curator of this wonderful exhibition. It's titled Earth, Air, Water, Fire, Balancing on the Edge. This is such a timely topic, and it's a theme that the artists who are in this exhibition and the poets who we've included feel so strongly about. Before I even looked for the venue, we had the theme together. And the theme of earth, air, water, and fire balancing on the edge was something that each of the artists really was concerned with. I'd like to first introduce to you Kelly Leahy Radding.
Thank you so much for putting this beautiful show together and curating. From my standpoint, when I started trying to think of how this fits for me and what I believe in and what I feel strongly about, I know, you know, many habitats, many animals, many plant species are balancing on the edge. I mean, they truly are. The peregrine, that's a bird of the air, is the fastest bird in the world. Of course he's air. That particular peregrine I saw in Yellowstone National Park, which is dear, 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 dear to my heart. And his story is they were virtually extinct in the 1970s, mostly due to DDT, causing their eggshells to be too fragile. They would break in the nest and the chicks would die. So there was literally pretty much one man that started a conservation effort called the Peregrine Fund, along with other volunteers, advocates, other conservation groups that worked with the government, was fighting the government. You probably remember the same thing happened to the bald eagles.
Peggy Sebera's body of work is called The Way of Water.
I have been working with the water theme, especially during this winter watery season and after all the fires from Northern California. So one of the paintings in the show represents the heat and the fire and the dryness. And then comes the water, which we so have needed here. And the passionate, emotional theme of understanding that we are on the edge with all of our environment.
Sanda Manuila has a very interesting background and story that comes into her paintings. You're not afraid to show us things that people would think, oh, that's horrible, that's terrible, and you're showing us the beauty.
Both. Each painting has a story. Like in 2017, we had all these natural disasters in the country, in Mexico, in various places, that there'd be earthquakes or hurricanes or whatever. And I thought, all this extreme weather is just a matter of mathematics until it's our turn. And if it's our turn, it would be fires, because the year before there were lots of fires in Northern California. Well, I started a painting of burning butterflies 2 months before the October fires. So it's like really, I could feel it. I could feel the danger. And so I did a whole series of fire paintings.
Heiko, tell us about the inspiration for your
work. The inspiration is more than just a forward-looking sort of evolutionary kind of thing. It comes from all angles of fantasy and biology. For me, it's a creation of a zoology that doesn't exist. And that's in our fantasy. In our fantasy, biology is perfect.
I invited Bill Stoesser to be a part of this exhibition because to me it speaks so much about the concern for the elements. His references are all about nature.
It could be something that I see and it germinates in my mind and something sticks, goes to paper, and then something works on paper, then I can translate it to wood. Going with it. There's always this gray and black in every color that I work with. I always incorporate it because it all, they start out as primary, but they all go toward earth colors. And even though some of they may look bright, I mean, there's a subdued quality.
Tobey Hiller and John Hart, and they're going to read their poems.
creature uncontrollably alight and taking us the way we don't desire, our separate adventures merge in fire.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.